You're watching Fox Sports, home to Major League Baseball, the Big Ten Championship, NASCAR, the UEFA Champions League Final, the UFC, and the NFL. The world's biggest events are on Fox Sports.
We are Fox Sports!
Over 150,000 fans are on hand as for the first time in the 65-year history of NASCAR's Premier Series, a woman, Danica Patrick, will take the green flag first today. Her competition includes the biggest and best names in the sport, Series champ Brad Keselowski, most popular driver Dale Earnhardt Jr.
This is where it all begins. The journey to become racing's ultimate champion starts with the biggest race of the year. Right here at NASCAR's most decorated and hallowed roads. Its beauty can often be overshadowed by its fierce intimidation. But if you can conquer this masterpiece, you will forever be remembered in racing lore. History has already been made leading up to this race. Who will make history today? It's 500 grueling miles, unsettling speeds, inches away from disaster, where anyone's dream can end at any second. But one driver will persevere and celebrate a moment that is etched in racing history. This is the great American race. This is the Daytona 500, right now on Fox.
From the World Center of Racing, Daytona International Speedway, Fox Sports proudly presents the 55th Daytona 500. America's favorite sport of speed is unique in that it begins its season with its biggest signature event. Hello, everyone. I'm Mike Joy, atop the flag stand at the start-finish line of this 2.5-mile super speedway, where yesterday, at the conclusion of the 300-mile nationwide series race, just 90 yards from the start-finish line, leader Regan Smith tagged by Brad Keselowski, Kyle Larson up and into the fence, where a fence post shears his car in half, and debris ends up on the wrong side of the fence. Workers were here till midnight repairing two fence posts, all the cabling and fencing, and we are ready to race. But 14 people were taken to local hospitals, two of them critically injured. The road to victory lane at Daytona, paved with great racing and some legendary finishes.
It is a spectacle among spectacles.
The famous Daytona 500.
Today is the greatest racing day of the year.
As a race fan, as a kid, you could not wait for the Daytona 500 to come on.
Daytona has always been the big deal.
From the sands of Daytona Beach to the 2.5-mile super speedway. It's one of our country's richest traditions.
Really gets things kicked off and gets people excited all around the country.
Be in my eyes.
The checkered flag. The race is over.
Be in my heart.
Look out, third turn. Out of control.
Be in my eyes. I. Be in my heart.
All the championships don't matter without a win here in this race.
To have a championship and not a Daytona 500 has a little something missing there.
Tony Stewart will come up short.
Mentally, it's exhausting.
Nothing comes easy in the 500.
They're head on the wall. The tempers overflowing.
The checkered flag is out. Riding, slamming in the wall.
But to overcome and pull into victory lane,
Dale Earnhardt will win the Daytona 500.
Well, that's a life-changing moment.
No, I got so excited that I punched the mirror out of my car.
I won the Daytona 500!
We are the people who rule the world. What's on
the horse the most coveted trophy in the sport.
If you stop and look at the names on that trophy, you realize you're an elite class of NASCAR racers.
The greatest thing a race car driver can be called is a Daytona 500 champion.
Win a NASCAR race, you've had a good year. Win the Harley Earl Trophy in the 500, and you've had a great career. Today's race features the debut of NASCAR's Generation 6 race car. Here's a look at NASCAR through the years. NASCAR's first racers are strictly stock cars. Rising speeds and safety concerns lead NASCAR to re-examine the design. NASCAR's greatest generation. The cars on track still look the same as in the showroom. Win on Sunday, sell on Monday becomes Detroit's battle cry. Shortened wheelbase cars begin moving away from stock appearance for aero efficiency. NASCAR mandates a restrictor plate to slow top speeds. Gen 4 cars remove all the stock from stock car racing. These are race cars, purpose-built for high downforce and low drag. The car of tomorrow. It's NASCAR's safest race car ever, but its aero-matched appearance leaves no distinct manufacturer identities, which leads us to Generation 6. Chevys, Fords, Toyotas, three unique body styles to put the stock back in stock car racing.
Ford Fusion.
Toyota Camry.
Chevy SS.
This is Generation 6.
This is Generation 6.
I think everything about the new car is pretty cool. You know, obviously we got a new look going this year.
Well, when I think of the Generation 6 car, I think of a car that's committed to looking like what you can actually buy on the street.
You know, it's nice to have this brand identity back.
Finally.
When you're driving down the highway and you see a Ford Fusion, it's going to look just like the Ford that I drive on the racetrack.
And when I look at it, I say, that's a Chevy. You know, that's a Ford, that's a Toyota, and we need that.
We're a little biased. We think the Chevy looks the best.
Now that the cars are so recognizable, the fans will really get more back into the Chevy versus Ford rivalry.
No matter whether you're a Ford fan or Chevy fan, you know, these people follow these brands and associate the drivers to the brand.
There's a lot of Toyota employees that are going to be excited about the car that they put on the street every single day. Now they get to see it on the racetrack.
The fans can relate to this car. I mean, you know, we win a race in this thing, and the fan gets to drive home in a car that looks just the same.
Because there's a lot of rivalries out there among the fans and the manufacturers. And I feel like we lost a little bit of that over the last several years.
I love these cars. You know, we're car guys. All of us are car guys.
This car is so much faster than the old car. The speeds with the Generation 6 car are for sure going to be higher.
There's no doubt at this point the Generation 6 car is drastically faster than the COT car.
Feels like you can kind of hustle it a little bit more. It feels like it's got, you know, more grip.
Track records that a lot of racetracks should follow, there's potential for a lot of those to be broken.
The speeds are definitely up. No one really knows what we're going to see. It's fast.
The cars are going to have really high speeds, but hey, that's what we're here for, is to race fast.
The drivers like the car, the fans love the look. Time to check in at our infield studio. That's the Hollywood Hotel proprietor, Chris Myers, with two hot shoes who have been there and won that.
Thanks a lot, Michael. Two-time Daytona 500 winner, and he's given it another shot. Michael Waltrip already in his fire suit. He'll rush to his car in a moment, and, of course, a Daytona 500 winner, Hall of Famer, three-time champ Darrell Waltrip, talking about the Gen 6 car. We'll get to that. But you were telling me you think this will be the best, greatest Daytona 500 ever. Why?
I believe more eyeballs will watch this race today than ever have before. And I tell you why. Danica Patrick on that's history. Folks, if you want to be a part of history today, you want to tune into this race. She's going to take the green flag from the number one spot. I got more texts and emails from 12, 15-year-olds saying, go, Danica, go. And that's what we're going to see today. She's going to make history, and it's going to be fun to watch.
How about driving the Generation 6 car? You've been in it. You'll be in it in a moment.
Well, you can hear the drivers. Their attitude is, this baby tickles my fancy. I like the way it feels. We have to understand exactly what it's going to be like with all 43 cars out there at once. We haven't seen that yet, and it's going to just intensify the action. We're going to see a lot of passing, a lot of three-wide racing. This baby is fast, and these drivers love it.
We are all concerned, obviously, about what happened, those involved in Saturday's accident. The effect on you, Darrell?
Yeah, well, when drivers get hurt, that's our problem. But when fans get hurt, that's everybody's problem. Safety's a chain, and we're always pulling on it. You never get comfortable with it. It's a moving target. We have to do some research here and see what we can do to make the walls safer and the fans safer.
Will Saturday's wreck alter anything you or the drivers do on the track today?
Well, my heart definitely hurts for those folks. But I'm going to tell you, when I put my helmet on and strap into that car, I put that to the side. I'm going to go race my car as hard as I can. And when I'm coming to the checkered flag, if it means moving a guy out of the way to get the win in the Daytona 500, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to race as hard as I can, as I know all my colleagues will as well.
And you'll be driving the 26 car for those in Newtown and in support. Of those.
I'm racing for a community, Chris. We're just hoping to heal and help people get have a great day today watching the Daytona 500. There's a big viewing party in Newtown, Connecticut, and we hope we can raise a lot of money and make people smile.
You don't have to be from Connecticut to realize how deeply difficult the loss of a child is. We are more connected than we'll ever know. All right, we'll talk with you guys a little bit later. More from the Hollywood Hotel coming up. Let's head back now to the flag stand again in Mike Joy.
Thank you, Chris. We have this 2.5-mile track covered like never before with analysts and reporters. And we welcome Aaron Andrews to our Daytona 500 coverage. And we'll push forward with cutting-edge technology today, like GyroCam. It stays vertical as the cars slam up into that 31-degree banking. You'll see it, you'll feel it. And our new Gen 6 cam flies across and over the tri-oval. How fast does that thing go? That was the question on the mind of NASCAR nationwide driver and extreme sports star, Travis Pastrana.
So I heard NASCAR on Fox has a really fast new camera. I wanted to find out just how fast. Game on. 35, 50, oh, it's still pulling away. 75, 95, we're almost keeping up. 110, oh, we got it!
The leading lady in not only NASCAR, but all of sports gives us her perspective on making history. Then, gear up as we trade in stock cars for a camo limo and uncover what it's like being Clint Boyer. Plus, an uncaged performance from the Grammy Award-winning Zac Brown Band. Then, the champ is here. Our own Aaron Andrews talks to Brad Keselowski about his plans to drive NASCAR to a new age. And an exclusive interview with all the drivers of that fast Hendrick foursome. Next, right here on Fox.
The Daytona 500 pre-race show is sponsored by Sprint. Millions of fans, one family. Only Sprint can feed them all. Join the family at sprint.com/speed.
After yesterday evening's incident at the end of the nationwide race, most everybody from every team had contacted somebody from our organization to ask what you could do, asked about the fans, and asked and expressed your thoughts and concerns. Those thoughts and concerns have been relayed to the fans and to their family members. And I just wanted to thank everybody because that's the character and the heart and soul of NASCAR, the way drivers and car owners and our crew members respond to things like that.
Encouraging words to the drivers and teams. Ladies first, not just chivalrous. Today, 42 men follow one woman to the green flag, a first for NASCAR's premier series. Danica Patrick reflects on her historic Speed Week.
This is going to put us on the front page of the newspaper, not just the sports section. Richard Petty. It's always cool to be the first one to do something, but to be honest, it's not something that I set really as a goal. For me, I was brought up to, you know, be the fastest driver and always get the most out of myself, and if that means records and firsts, then so be it. Whoever starts on the pole is about a 17% chance of winning, so I like that. I think that's okay. You know, I'm a rookie, and I have a lot to learn, and there's so many good drivers out there, so a 17% chance of winning sounds like a good start to me. When Jeff's daughter, Ella Gordon, wanted to take a picture with me, she also said that she wanted to be a race car driver, and so I stood there, and I was like, what do Mom and Dad think about that? I was very flattered that that Ella even knew my name. That was a special little moment in victory lane. I just think of her as another driver, not a female driver, Brad Keselowski. I feel like, you know, people are always a little bit surprised by kind of all the different things that I do. I am far less serious, far less intense looking, very girly when I get away from the track. I love shopping and pedicures. It's also nice at the end of a long day when you're working and you're at the track to want to go grab a sandwich and a beer. I think that balances it all out. I was brought up to be the fastest driver, not the fastest girl, Danica Patrick. I really only think of myself as an athlete and as a competitor and as a race car driver. To be at the top of the charts at any point in time is exactly what I set out to do, and it feels good and doesn't feel weird to me. Growing up racing go-karts, and I won plenty of races, and I was the only girl out there, so I'd just like to get back to that place again.
In early January, Danica's odds of winning were 500-1, but things have changed. From humble beginnings, NASCAR's greatest stars, Petty, Pearson, Earnhardt, became working man's heroes. They had talent, swagger, and a quiet confidence. In that grand tradition, here comes driver number 15, being Clint Bowyer.
Anytime you come from no money and then all of a sudden are thrown into a situation where you're making, you know, a substantial amount of money, well, what do you do with it? Coming from Kansas and growing up with tow trucks and working in a body shop, still to this day, I always ask myself, how in the hell did this all come true? Sam! This car was built for absolute laughs. I'm in it for about $3,500, and it's probably the most fun vehicle I've ever had. You know, I've just been very fortunate to find a job that I love to do and enjoy every day. Every day is something different. I own a dirt racing shop. I'm just one of the guys, and that's what I want to be. Too much horsepower, too much brakes, too much fun. An office is something I never had and always wanted. And then once I built one, I wondered why the hell I even built it, because I'm never in here. I hate sitting down.
There's a hammer. I'm not gonna sit at home on the couch and read a book. I can get through about the first page and I'm going to find some action somewhere.
Hey boy, give five. You wanna go get some ice cream?
Lincoln's the best, man.
You go put it in truck. You were raised
on I'm kind of the guy after a year. That's when Uncle Clint comes in. I can handle that situation. Put your hair down, hair down.
Some of this laid on back. Kick your shoes off, kick them off. Can't believe we couldn't ride four-wheelers. It's almost as good, though, huh?
Just because I have a camouflage limousine, I'm not full redneck hillbilly. I definitely like cleaning up and going to the city. Do whatever you want. I'm gonna wear a hat anyway. That hat's going back on.
We're down on the town, baby. Is that good? Is that close? We don't wear ties very often in Kansas. What do you think about white socks with dress shoes?
I want fans to watch the race on TV and think, man, there's a guy I'd like to have a beer with. I think being true to who you are is everything, but I think it's not letting yourself get out of bounds, not letting yourself go to an event and think you're somebody you're not.
Hey. Man, I know I got a Gordon jacket. Thank you so much.
Get out. Get out. Oh, we don't take stairs, sir. I'm so joking.
We're in the business of building brands. You've got to be outspoken. You've got to separate from the other guys.
Do you know any Clint?
No, I don't know no Clint.
Damn, I'm sorry.
Somehow, you've got to find your own niche, but damn sure have a good time doing it.
Finally.
Bowyer is last year's runner-up for the Sprint Cup Championship. Coming up, Aaron Andrews goes one-on-one with defending champ Brad Keselowski. And Team Hendrick sits down and opens up with Chris Myers. Welcome back to Daytona International Speedway. site of today's 55th running of the Daytona 500. Let's go trackside and welcome Erin Andrews.
Hey, thanks so much. You know, Brad Keselowski may be NASCAR's reigning champ, but that means absolutely nothing to him as he gets set to start this new season. In fact, his mindset is everyone starts with a clean slate, and his confidence has him feeling no pressure to repeat as champion.
Brad Keselowski leading here at Kentucky.
He will win
his third victory in 2012.
As Brad Keselowski looks to be cruising to the
so
win.
So far, so good for Brad Keselowski in charge, headed for three.
2012 Sprint Cup Series champ.
I'm waking up to action dust. I wipe my brow and I sweat my rust. I'm breathing in the chemicals.
You are now carrying around this huge bullseye on your back. You come to media day, other drivers are talking about you. How has that been?
I don't ever feel bullseye. I just never have. And I don't anticipate I ever will because I enjoy it. It's another chance for me to prove that, you know, I have what it takes to be a champion.
How much do you worry about what the other drivers say or think about you?
I try not to, but I would be lying. I'd be lying. I said, I don't worry at all because you do. You have to understand that when you're in a sport like racing, your fate can be more easily dictated by someone else than it can be yourself. But on the other side of that, you have to always remember that in order to really know you're successful, the measuring stick for that is when other people hate you.
You know? That's good.
The most flattering thing that could ever happen to a race car driver is to be booed. Because you know when that happens, you pissed off every other fan out there that's mad that their driver's not winning and you're beating them.
It's a revolution, I suppose. We're painted red to fit right in.
Jimmy Johnson wasn't booing you at media day, but he did address your maturity. He said, you have the best intentions for our sport, for your sponsor, but you need to mature a little. What do you think about that?
He was just trying to play head games with me to make me feel like I'm not good enough to be in the same league as him. I know I'm doing something right when there's people criticizing me.
The head games are part of it.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah.
I don't think he knows me well enough to know that that's not going to work.
We're so adamant about being different. Why do they need this new, different attitude? Why does NASCAR need this?
Well, I think that the sports world is changing. And I think to be relevant, authenticity is what fans crave. And it's okay to showcase that.
All systems go.
Is this the start to a new age in NASCAR?
If I have my choice, yes. I'd like to see the sport be fresh. You know, I don't think we can all be the same. I don't feel like every driver should be this cookie cutter, you know, I love my sponsor, da, da, da.
Why do you like ruffling people's feathers the way you do?
I like to break people out of the box that they live in. It helps me realize who's fake, who's not. It just makes me feel like I'm doing something worthwhile.
So is that why you have this I want to be different persona? I want to say what I feel because there are people that can relate to you that don't want to just be the same cookie cutter driver?
I feel like I fell into this persona because I want to leave the sport better than what it was when I entered it. And in order to do that, we have to do things differently.
And Mike, you want to know how different Brad wants to be? At the beginning of the week when we were shooting our beauty shots with him, he asked one of our producers, what did the other drivers do? I want to be absolutely different and separate from all of them.
Sometimes different is better. Now let's meet a Daytona 500 champion and his special 7-month-old good luck charm. Kevin Harvick. The closer.
I think I put little Keelan back in the car. Twice he's been in the car, twice a win.
He's going to be hard to handle.
Kevin Harvick wins the Sprint Unlimited.
Woohoo! That's one for the lame ducks, right?
More to come.
That's right.
It's been a spectacular speed weeks for Kevin Harvick already with 2 wins. Can you win the Daytona 500?
I don't see why not. Our Budweiser Chevrolet has been good, but a lot more laps, a lot of unknowns today with all the cars on the racetrack, and I'm just going to go hammer down and see what happens.
Now, to this point, Kevin, it seems like your good luck charm has been your young son, Keelan. You've put him in the seat. Does he go in the seat before the 500?
Oh, yeah. He's definitely going in. Hopefully it works out the same way it has the first 2 days. But, yeah, he's up-dressed, and we made sure that we timed those naps correctly today. So driver intros went like they were supposed to.
All right. Hey, best of luck in the Great American Race.
Thank you.
Thanks, Steve. Next up, Team Hendrick sits down with Chris Myers. Grammy-winning Zac Brown Band performs, and special driver intros kick off the 55th 500.
The Daytona 500 pre-race show is sponsored by Aaron's. You don't need credit. All you need is Aaron's. By Sunoco, the official fuel of NASCAR. And by DreamWorks The Cruise, March 22nd, only in theaters.
These three-time Grammy Award winners have become one of the top-selling artists touring today. Performing songs off their Grammy Award-winning album, Uncaged, please welcome Zac Brown Band.
And the wicked is a churn as the southern wind sings again. And I love a mind. You can jump right, feel the music pull you in. You can jump right, or lose yourself again as the southern wind sings again. And I love a the locals go, no one knows where to find it. When the river starts to flow inside the clouds of misty mountain, water from this stone below becomes a blue-green fountain as the southern wind sings again, a night of lullaby. You can jump right in. If you get the notion, stop on by and play a while. Simple tune to get your love light glow. Keep your heart wide open, disappear just like the tide. Let it roll on by. Jump right in. Feel the music pull you in. You can jump right in. Unloose yourself again.
Jump right in, feel the music pull you in, get jump right in, feel the music pull you in, as the sun wind
up in the land of the great wide open. Let the water roll on over me. I'm
proud to announce our Fox Sports Supports charities for 2013 are Feeding America, John Hopkins Medicine, and Stop Out Bullying. We'll raise awareness for these organizations all year long.
Let's
on the Fox Sports networks and platforms. Go to foxsportssupports.com. Coming up, you'll meet all 43 drivers starting the Daytona 500. Two men and one woman about to drive off into history. To introduce them, public address announcer Jim Mueller.
Race fans, let's meet the starting lineup for the 55th running of the Daytona 500. Starting 43rd in the number 93 Burger King Toyota, Travis Quaffle. In row 21, in the number 83, Burger King Toyota, David Rudeman. And driving the number 36, Golden Corral Chevrolet, J.J. Yaley. In row 20, it's the number 51, Phoenix Construction Chevrolet, with Regan Smith aboard. And the number 32, C&J Energy Services Ford, driven by Terry Labonte. Row 19 has the 98 Caleb Curb Records Ford, driven by Michael McDowell. And the number 56 Napa Auto Parts Toyota, Martin Truex Jr., the driver. In row 18, the number 99 Fastenal Ford of Carl Edwards. And the number 11 FedEx Express Toyota, driven by Denny Hamlin. In row 17, the number 39 Quicken Loans Chevrolet 2008 Daytona 500 champion, Ryan Newman. And in the number 21 Motorcraft Quick Lane Tire and Auto Center Ford, the 2011 Daytona 500 champion, Trevor Bayne. In row 16, the number 35 MDS Transport Ford, driven by Josh Wise. And the number 35 Levain Family Racing Ford, driven by Scott Speed. In row 15, it's the number 7 Florida Lottery Chevrolet, the driver Dave Blaney. And the number 26 Sandy Hook School Support Fund Toyota, two-time Daytona 500 champion Michael Waltrip. In row 14, the number 17 Best Buy Ford, driven by Ricky Stenhouse Jr. And the number 87 Maddie's Place Rocks.com DAV Constructors Toyota, with Joe Nemechek aboard. In row 13, the number 43 Smithfield Ford, driven by Eric Almirola. And driving the number 38 Loves Travel Stops Ford, David Gilliland. Row number 12 has the number 9 Stanley Ford, driven by Marcus Ambrose. And the number 47 Kroger Toyota, with Bobby Labonte. In row 11, it's the 34 Detail Dr. Ford, driven by David Reagan. And driving the number 22 Shell Pennzoil Ford, Joey Logano. Starting 10th in the number 1 McDonald's Chevrolet, the 2010 Daytona 500 champion, Jamie McMurray. And in the number 88 National Guard Chevrolet, 2004 Daytona 500 champion, Dale Earnhardt Jr. Starting in row number 9 in the 31 Caterpillar Chevrolet, Jeff Burton. And in the number 13 Geico Ford, driver Casey Mears. In row 8, the number 27 Menards Peak Chevrolet, driven by Paul Menard. And in the number 2 Miller Lite Ford, Brad Keselowski. In row number 7, driving the number 55 Aaron's Dream Machine Toyota, Mark Martin. And in the number 14 Bass Pro Shops Mobile One Chevrolet, Tony Stewart. Row 6 has the number 20 Dollar General Toyota, two-time Daytona 500 champion, Matt Kenseth. And driving the number 78 Furniture Row Racing Chevrolet, Kurt Busch. In row 5, driving the number 15 5-Hour Energy Toyota, Clint Boyer. And driving the number 48 Lowe's Chevrolet, the 2006 Daytona 500 champion, Jimmy Johnson. In row number 4, driving the number 33 Honey Nut Cheerios Chevrolet, Austin Dillon. And in the number 42 Target Chevrolet, Juan Pablo Montoya. In row number 3, it's the number 5 Farmers Insurance Chevrolet, driven by Casey Kane. And the number 16 3M Ford, driven by Greg Biffle. Row number 2 has the 18 M&M's Toyota, driven by Kyle Busch. And the number 29 Budweiser Chevrolet, driven by 2007 500 champion Kevin Harvick. In row number 1, the number 24 Drive to End Hunger Chevrolet, three-time Daytona 500 champion Jeff Gordon. And starting on the pole for the 55th running of the Daytona 500, in the number 10 GoDaddy Chevrolet, Danica Patrick.
Well, there's the class of 2013. 13 Daytona 500 victories among these 43 drivers. Coming up, Chris Myers goes a few hot laps with the Hendrick team.
The Daytona 500 pre-race show is sponsored by the entirely new Ford Fusion. There's still one thing it can't do.
NASCAR The Game Inside Line puts you in the driver's seat. It's the most realistic, officially licensed NASCAR game ever. Plus, the best moments from the 2013 season will be recreated as downloadable packs each week. Relive and even rewrite the wildest moments of the Daytona 500 and beyond with NASCAR The Game Inside Line.
Well, NASCAR just called. They would like their flag stand back. I'm going to head up to the booth and join Larry McReynolds. Let's check you back in at the Hollywood Hotel and Chris Myers.
All right, Mike, we'll be catching up with you in a moment. It's a good time to take a look at some of the names you're likely to hear called out when they wave the checkered flag at the finish line. The four drivers of the Hendrick Motorsports team have won a combined 5 Daytona 500s and 9 championships. They are the Tom Brady Patriots of NASCAR. If they don't win the title, they're at least always in the conversation. And all four made NASCAR's playoffs last year.
You ready?
Get some, get it. Keep giving.
Great to be here at the House of Hendrick and the super team of Hendrick drivers. How often do you guys, when it's not racing related, how often do you guys hang out, you four?
that's your first question?
Yes. It's always, yeah, man, let's get together and do dinner. And nothing ever happens.
A long time ago, we all had similar things.
Lifestyles.
Yeah. Things have changed a little bit in the last few years for everybody.
I see him at birthday parties.
Right.
They hang, hang
kids
out.
Kids' birthday parties.
So
I'm still doing the same things you guys used to do.
He's carrying up the back.
And he's kind of in the middle.
In between.
It's a new dawn, it's a new day, it's a new life for me, and I'm feeling good.
In other sports, we got the Yankees with their image, the Miami Heat they put together and then finally won a championship. Would you agree that this is the super team of NASCAR?
There's pressure that's assumed when you sign on the dotted line and come to work here that you've got to perform and you'll have that opportunity to, but we don't consciously think about it as much as others do.
When I came on board and signed with Hendrick, people were questioning my move. You know, they hadn't won a championship at that point. So over the years, those expectations started building.
Having four drivers of this caliber, does that give Hendrick Motorsports an unfair advantage?
Everybody has the same opportunity. When I started, you know, the word was, you'll never win a championship running multiple cars. You know, I had always learned from my experience at the dealership side, the more smart people you can put together, the better off you are.
Hendrick's team next year will include Jeff Gordon, Jimmy Johnson, and Dale Earnhardt Jr. Is there enough room on the marquee for all three of these drivers?
I came here curious. I'd seen the things that Jeff had done. And I talked to Jimmy several times about how cool I thought it'd be to have the opportunity to drive for Rick, and I wanted to go to the best place.
Basically, they compete, and they're friends, and they want to beat each other on the racetrack. I see it sometimes. Right. They start beating on each other, and I just race a little hard, and I'll say, okay, hey, remember the big picture. That's all I got to say.
What's awesome is what was created here and how we work together and how we share information, the database and the crew chief meetings and drivers meetings. That's amazing, really, when you look at what we're doing, because on Sunday we're competing with one another.
We ran 1, 2, 3 in the points a few years back, and on that last race, we knew one of them was going to win it, and they shared information, pitted beside each other.
It doesn't all really make sense until you see the benefits that it brings each and every weekend, and at the end of the year, having all four teams in that championship, what a great accomplishment that is, and how proud it makes Rick.
Come on around and win. Let one up around the bend.
Is there someone who's more competitive than the other, or at least maybe shows it more?
I'd say Jeff probably shows it the most.
I don't know exactly what that was supposed to mean. I don't think that was a compliment.
That's a compliment.
It was? It was
okay, the first time I ever raced Jeff at Martinsville, he's passing me. He probably lapped me. I'm not sure. And he just pointed left. And I was like, he's going to run over me, or I'm going to lift, one or the other. And I lifted. Like, it was just...
Thank you.
Like, I kind of learned then.
I think we've seen it more with you. We all have it. We just all show it in different ways.
I was going to say, you put a helmet on any of us, and we change.
So I have the grease board real quick. I'm going to give you each one, and I'm gonna ask you, since we're talking horsepower and star power at the Hendrick House, if all four of you are racing and everything's equal, the car, the track, the pit crew, who wins out of the four of you? And you can't pick yourself.
Oh,
whatever track you think, but write down.
I think they all say the same thing. even Jimmy's. I mean, it's hard to go against five times.
Five time? Okay. Jimmy and...
same thing.
Junior took Jimmy and...
Who's your board?
Yeah, I...
We don't take off for spelling, don't worry. Look at that. See, that's what I mean about the respect.
I just saw a bonding moment between these two.
However you spell it, you know, Dale Earnhardt Jr., when I asked Jeff Gordon, what about that same grease board bit for today's race, he said Junior's the guy.
You know why? Because Junior is the heir apparent to his father's legacy. People said that Dale Sr. could see the heir, and that's kind of where the Earnhardt legacy stands. I think Junior always will be a factor here at Daytona.
Hendrick, the super team, do they have an edge? And you saw them talk about the teamwork. Those are the drivers are the front guys. But do they have an advantage with the Generation 6 car?
A couple of things. Rick started off with a bunch of outlaws. He had me, and he had Jeff Bodine. He had Kenny Schrader. He had Tim Richmond. I think Rick realized it's a lot easier to manage a bunch of all-stars. Which is what he has now. But anybody that walks into Hendrick Motorsports, and they're there very long, I know Casey Kane did, I know Dale Jr. did it, they look around and they say, how am I supposed to compete against this? The most resources of anybody in the sport.
And they make it play. All right, time now for Gas and Go. If you have questions, we have answers, and you're on the clock.
I'm happy
about this.
All right,
Daryl. Matt Kenseth has won two of the last four Daytona 500s last year, but a career in Ford. Now he's in a Joe Gibbs Racing Toyota. How does that affect his chances today?
I've been watching him in practice and in the 150. He seems to be a little bit out of his comfort zone. Remember, only car he ever drove was a 17 car. Only team he ever drove for was Roush. He's got a new spotter. He's got a new crew chief. He's on a new team. He's got to find his sweet spot.
Only three drivers have won the Daytona 500 in back-to-back years, so that's a challenge. Brothers coached against each other in the Super Bowl. They've raced against each other. But what challenges do rookies Danica Patrick and Ricky Stenhouse Jr. face since they are dating each other and competing today against each other?
I've given this a bit of thought. And what drew them together was what will drive them apart. And I think that's racing. I think that's competition. I think when they get on the track and start to compete for Rookie of the Year, and remember, they're totally opposite. One drives a Chevrolet, the other drives a Ford. He's a little country. She's a little rock and roll. I don't know how this relationship's going to work out, but I think racing will be the test.
I have heard them say they would wreck their mother to win, so that tells us something about them. All right.
I've heard that before.
Five drivers won their first NASCAR Cup title in consecutive years, you among them. So how difficult, and we've heard from Brad Keselowski earlier in the show, but how difficult for him, especially since he's going from a Dodge to a Ford to defend his Cup title?
Yeah, there's so much pressure to defend your title, but here's the thing. I always call it a hangover. It seems like that by the time you get through celebrating your championship, that it distracts you from getting ready for the next year. And then in Keselowski's case, they've changed manufacturers.
All right, real quick, the Gen 6 car, what's it like?
It's like getting off the old car is like a mule, and this car is like a thoroughbred.
And your pick today?
Well, my buddy Bubba from Franklin, Tennessee, said to bet the farm on the Biff. I'm going with the Biff.
Greg Biffle. All right, so many ways to take in today's race, the grandstand, the infield, on top of the camper, and at home watching on your television. Our Jeff Hammond found another vantage point with the Grand Marshal, who's also Oz, the great and powerful.
Yeah, that's right, Chris. I'm down here with James Franco. You're the star of Oz, the Great and Powerful. Now, the main thing is, you're the guy that's going to get this whole show started. Are you ready for that? You got a lot of responsibility.
Well, it's only four words, but I heard when you did it, Jeff, it took you a teleprompter, cue cards, and about 10 takes.
So you're going to start picking on me, too. I mean, just because you're the Oz, right, it doesn't
Jeff,
mean you got to...
I'll see you later.
Whoa. Okay. All right. Okay. But look, with the Daytona 500 is getting ready to start. Bring me back down. Hurry up. Look, quit playing. Quit playing.
A lot happening as the drivers head to their cars and are ready to go. In the Great American Race, you're watching the Daytona 500 live on Fox.
Between Cale Yarborough and Donnie Allison.
20 years of trying, Dale Earnhardt will win the Daytona 500.
What are the special memories created here as we get ready to start the 55th running of the Great American Race, and spectators from all 50 states and more than 40 countries here in attendance. Well, you just heard from Jeff Hammond in the hot air balloon. You're going to hear the drivers today and throughout the broadcast referring to drafting quite a bit. It's almost like a turbulent wake behind a boat. And legend has it that the late Dale Earnhardt could see the air in the draft. Darrell referenced that moments ago. And drafting will have a lot to do with the winner of today's race. So let's check back in with Jeff Hammond.
When NASCAR developed the Gen 5, or commonly known as the Car of Tomorrow, they decided that making the bumpers, and I'm talking about the front bumper and the rear bumper, aligned would be a really good idea. That way, when drivers bumped into one another, well, maybe they wouldn't spin each other out quite as quick. But one thing did come out of the two-car tandem. When the drivers figured out the two cars hooked up and pushing one another so tightly with these flat surfaces that they were faster than the big pack, well, in 2013, NASCAR and the manufacturers changed the game. Three different manufacturers, three distinctive shapes, styles, and overall looks. But the one thing they have in common is the fact you don't see the flat front end. So what does that mean? Well, these guys get together, they don't align like they did in 2012, and we've already seen the results of that. In my opinion, that's the reason why pack racing once again king at Daytona.
Thanks a lot, Jeff. We appreciate that. For the drivers, by the way, representing 23 states, seven drivers from California in this race, the most of any one state. Well, Daytona's version of the Hollywood red carpet is the gridwalk. All the special effects you're going to see today are real. There are no stuntmen for the best drivers in the world. This is reality TV gone wild. So let's head down there live to the track and say hi again to Erin Andrews.
Hi, Chris, and thanks for letting me have some fun in your world. Absolutely, this is reality TV. I cannot believe that this is pit row. I'm going to give you an up-close and personal view of what this is like really 20 minutes before this show gets on the road. This is what these drivers have to deal with. Look at all this entourage. Can you imagine Jim Harbaugh having to deal with this? This is a ton of people here. Kevin Harvick, how do you even concentrate as you get ready to get in your car, go about 200 miles an hour, when your office looks like this?
Well, you know that this is part of the game before you get started. So, once you get in a car and you can flip the switch and everything changes from there. But right now, it's our sport is about the fans and the sponsors, and this is what it takes to make it go around.
I don't know many NFL or college football coaches that would love this moment right here. All right, let's keep moving here. Of course, there's Matt Kenseth. He won Daytona 500 last year. You guys talked about it in the show. He's with a new team, a new car, a new sponsor. He said this week he feels like a new kid starting school here. Jimmy Johnson's car is over here. I just saw him walk by a minute ago. It's, of course, everybody waiting around with him. The one cool thing about the Daytona 500, as we've seen, as we've been hanging out here, are there are so many celebrities from outside the sport, actors, musicians, entrepreneurs, everybody just wanting to get an up-close and personal look at what is happening over here. And we're going to move it forward a little bit and go to the person who has stole the spotlight here at the Daytona 500. That's, of course, Danica Patrick, who made history earlier this week and is on the verge of making history. We're gonna try to see if we can talk to her. Of course, 50 Cent here. I gotta go talk to Danica Patrick. Good to see you. What are you doing here?
I'm enjoying myself. I'm enjoying all the festivities while we rolling. So
we're gonna go see Danica. Can you guys believe this? Let's weed our way through here. Gotta find her. Can we find her? We're still looking here. Well, I don't think we can find her. Chris, I cannot believe this is what you deal with all the time. Thank you so much for letting me be a part of this. Thank goodness 50 Cent is here, though, guys. We're going to send it back over to you.
All right, thanks. Appreciate it, Aaron. We got 50 Cent. We were hoping to get Danica's 2 cents before Danica Patrick takes off from the pole. The Great American Race, the 55th running of the Daytona 500. We're glad you're with us for NASCAR on Fox.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, we ask that you please rise and remove your hats as the Mayport Naval Station Color Guard presents our nation's colors. Please remain standing as Reverend L. Ronald Durham from the Greater Friendship Missionary Church offers today's invocation.
Let us pray. Lord, we ask your blessings upon this running of the Daytona 500. Guide the drivers around each turn. Set your angels before them. Protect the racers and those in the stands. Grant a speedy recovery to those fans that were injured on Saturday. As we look at the red, white, and blue of the flag, protect our sons and daughters fighting to keep America strong. We praise you and thank you for your promise and your power through Christ. Amen and Godspeed.
Here to perform our national anthem, a member of the three-time Grammy Award-winning Zac Brown Band, please welcome Clay Cook.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hail as the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, the ramparts we watched were so gallantly streaming, and the rockets' red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Anxious anticipation. Danica Patrick was just 10 years old when Jeff Gordon ran at his first Daytona 500. They'll be side by side on the front row. Back here in Daytona, and that is Keelan. You saw him earlier in the pre-race show. 7 months old on the good luck charm for Father Kevin Harvick. And there is owner and driver Tony Stewart, who's never won a Daytona 500. He's won everything else. Talking to Danica Patrick, who starts on the pole making history. And can she get to victory lane? Danica in a Chevrolet, and earlier in Speed Weeks here at Daytona, GM President Mark Royce, joined by Jeff Gordon, unveiling the new 2014 Chevrolet SS sedan, streetcar companion to the Gen 6 Cup car. And the drivers like what they see.
First time I saw it was like, wow.
It looks fantastic.
It's the only rear-wheel drive car in the mix.
Yeah, that car's something special.
When you look at the nose of the car, you're gonna know it's a Chevy design for sure.
It just looks like a really sexy, sporty Chevy.
And Chevrolet has the most wins of any manufacturer here at the Great American Race in the 55th running of the Daytona 500. Drivers looking almost like superheroes as they strap into their cars. Jimmy Johnson, Dale Earnhardt Jr. There's Clint Bowyer, second in points last year, and a guy who has run well on restrictor plate races. Tony Stewart is the favorite in Las Vegas for this race at 8-1, followed by Kevin Harvick, Dale Earnhardt Jr., and Jeff Gordon. Danica Patrick listed at 20-1. We're glad to have you along for coverage of the Daytona 500. This is NASCAR on Fox and ready to head trackside for opening ceremonies.
And now, for the most famous words in motorsports, please welcome your Grand Marshal from the upcoming film Disney's Oz the Great and Powerful, James Franco.
Drivers and Danica, start your engines!
Command with command. Temperature in the 70s. The rain chances are diminishing, and NASCAR's opening day and Super Bowl packed into 1 4-hour thrill ride. So let's head up to the booth to the voices of NASCAR on Fox. Darrell Waltrip, Larry McReynolds, and Mike Joy. Mike?
Thank you, Chris. Darrell Waltrip, the 89 winner of this race. What a contrast on the front row. A Sunoco Rookie of the Year candidate lined up next to a four-time series champion.
Yeah, the winningest driver in the modern era, Jeff Gordon, with 87 wins, going against Danica, who only has 10 starts. I think the question is going to be, she's a rookie. Is it what she doesn't know, is what she doesn't know going to help her? Or is the experience of the guys around her going to hurt her? I believe these guys are going to allow it. She's got a fast car. That could be her ticket.
Larry McReynolds won this race twice from pit road. And Larry, the second row are two of the most aggressive drivers in this business who each won their Daytona dual race on Thursday.
And the other thing that Kyle Busch and Kevin Harvick have in common, they don't care about anything but winning this Daytona 500. And the stories with those two drivers. Kyle Busch only won one race last year, missed the chase, and he's never won this 500. Kevin Harvick, essentially with two races to go at the end of last year, announced that he was leaving Richard Childress Racing at the end of 2013. He's backed that up by winning three of the last four races, including the Sprint Unlimited and the Budweiser Duel on Thursday, trying to become the first driver in the history to sweep all three races during Speed Weeks.
And that's just the front two rows of the 43 drivers that are about to square off in stock car racing's biggest event, the 55th Daytona 500 on Fox.
Who will win the Great American Race, the biggest race of the year?
It is a big, big deal.
Here they come.
Maybe you can find me in the back of a jacked up tailgate. Watching all these pretty things. I'm getting down in that Georgia clay and I'll find peace. Bottom of a real tall cold drink. Chilling with some Skinner and some Unleashed. Let's get this thing started. It's my kind of party.
This place is fast. It's intimidating. And what will happen next?
Boogity, boogity, boogity! Let's go racing, boys!